Hello, guys, and welcome to the briefing room. We'll get right to it and open up our flight dispatch release. Looking at the first page, we can see that the flight took place on the 1st of February 2016, and it's from Los Angeles to San Francisco. I'm recording this post commentary quite a bit later because it takes a lot of time to edit these videos. We'll be flying a Boeing 757-200 with the registration November 633 Delta Lima. Our ATC call sign for today is going to be United 480. Looking at the general route overview on the right-hand side, we'll be cruising at a speed given by the cost index, and the cost index today is 10, which is fairly slow. So that means basically that the airplane will be cruising at a fairly low speed. Basically, it's just a measure of how much fuel to conserve versus how quickly to fly. The average wind component today is going to be minus 62 knots, so we'll have an approximately 62 knot headwind on average. And it's plus 12 degrees versus the international standard atmosphere temperature, which means it's basically a warm weather and quite a bit of headwind. Our alternate for today is going to be Sacramento, Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot. And our flight level today on the cruise is going to be flight level 380 from Los Angeles. Looking down at the fuel breakdown, I'm just going to quickly go over the block fuel is basically the estimate for how much we're going to burn and how much we're going to need for all of our reserves. Heading over to the next page, we can see on the right-hand upper side one last recap of the final reserve. That basically just puts together the fuel we'll need for to reach our alternate airport, the final reserve of 30 minutes, and a contingency of 5% on a fuel load. Looking at the alternate breakdown, if we have multiple alternates, this line would this section here would contain multiple lines, but in this case it only contains Sacramento, with a planned landing altitude of 34 right, a track of 0 to 9 and 74 miles to go to a direct. If we get a direct down of Sacramento, if we have to divert, at a flight level of 100, a flight level of 110, and a wind component of minus 12, we'll estimate to be about 27 minutes until we reach our alternate, and we have planned 3,900 pounds of fuel for that. Next important line here is the MEL CDL item, so we have no faults on the airplane as reported by maintenance, so the airplane is in a good state, and there are no reported problems with it. The route we'll be flying is takeoff from 25 right from Los Angeles, then the Ventura 5 departure, San Marcos transition, direct to Surfer, and from Surfer we'll go straight into the arrival, which is the Surfer 2 arrival, down to San Francisco on the 2 and planned landing on 28 left. Looking at the payload breakdown and the time breakdown on page 3, we can see that we estimate a block time of 1 hour and 22 minutes versus a scheduled time of 1 hour and 30. That's what I've been given by United Virtual Dispatch, so we should be able to make the flight without any trouble. The payload weight is also given by dispatch, so we'll be estimating 171 passengers, giving us a total payload of 39,300 pounds, given a zero fuel weight on the airplane of 171,900. Fuel load 17.1, which is just from page 2, giving us a total takeoff weight of 188.5, way below our maximum of 205,900 pounds. Landing weight, given the estimated en route burn, is going to be 180,600 pounds. Looking at the route overview from top down, you can see we'll be taking off from Southern California, Los Angeles, and tracking up pretty much along the coast, and just straight into San Francisco. This is a very high efficiency route. If we have to divert to Sacramento, it'll be due to northeast from where San Francisco is. The weather is a very important part here, and we can see that the weather at San Francisco and Los Angeles is kind of interesting. We have a fair amount of wind. So at Los Angeles, we're looking at winds coming from 260, 31 gusting 37 knots. So it's aligned with the runway, but it's a fairly hefty headwind with some gusting. So we'll be expecting a little bit of turbulence on departure. Statute maximum visibility broken at 2,500 feet. So clouds, we'll be entering the clouds pretty much right after departure. 13 degrees, 8 degrees dew point, and a low altimeter setting of 2963, which, as you can see, as you'll see in a second there, means that we're flying in a convective cell, basically a convective area here. So there's a fair amount of warm air that's causing a bunch of intense weather being thrown off into our area here. San Francisco is much the same, even though it's about 300 miles to the north. So these temperature, these kinds of warm cells are fairly substantial in size. San Francisco is reporting winds coming from 290-29, gusting 40. So again, about 11 knots of gust excess, also aligned with the runway almost directly. 10 statute miles visibility and few clouds at 2,100 feet and a few at 3,800 feet. 12 degrees C static air temperature and 2 degrees on the dew point. Again, altimeter setting is below 2,909 or 2, so 2,978, indicating again that there's going to be some warm weather out there. The forecast for arrival is going to be even a little bit worse. The winds are not expected to change pretty much throughout the evening. So 290-30 gusting 45 and a greater than 6 statute miles visibility. The alternate weather is somewhat less intense, which is why the alternate was picked there. It's 320-21 gusting 27, 10 statute miles and a little bit higher clouds, cloud layers, a little bit less cloud coverage. And yeah, overall, the weather at Sacramento, should we not be able to make an approach on San Francisco due to weather, we should be able to do it at Sacramento without any trouble. We have some signets issued for our area. So we have a turbulence signet issued for from California and the coastal area waters from Hector to Buzzard VOR to, I think that's Mission Bay to San Marcos to Hector, occasional severe turbulence below flight level 100. So we can expect that this has been reported by other aircraft. So we can expect that these conditions are going to be hitting us pretty much as soon as we take off. Then we also have a convective signet, which basically reinforces the warm weather theory that I've iterated just a little bit before, which is also moving along the coasts there. And it's moving from north, so it's moving from the west at about 30 knots and tops out at about 280, gusts up to 40 knots possible. You could expect some cumulonimbus clouds potentially in a convective signet. And the last signet we have issued is for rime icing. So we would expect to see possibly between flight levels 80 and 150 to have some severe rime icing, which means we'll probably be turning on the anti-ice if we see any kind of visible moisture there. Looking at the overhead overview of the weather situation here, as you can see, we have the zone of up to flight level 370. We'll be flying in that, where we expect potential light turbulence. Our cruise altitude of 380 should be taking us above that, but as we are climbing through that, we might be getting some turbulence occasionally on the way. Looking at the weather, at the wind chart, to again reiterate, we'll be having a fair amount of headwind here. So at flight level 390, we have an estimated, we're flying not quite in the jet stream. The jet stream appears to be a little bit more south of us, but we have a fair amount of headwinds here, typical for this kind of area and this direction of flight. Looking on the side profile here for the flight, this basically just reinforces that the winds are pretty much continuously going to be in our disfavor and our disadvantage all the way down to the ground level. And you can see the blue dotted line there, or blue dashed line, is the tropopause layer, which has descended quite a bit. Usually it's at around 36,000 feet. Right now here it's forecast to be at 28 to 27,000 feet. The tropopause is a layer of air where basically above the tropopause, the typical trend of temperature decreasing with altitude kind of stops or severely diminished. So basically above that, you don't get much of a temperature drop after passing that altitude and climbing up even further than that. Just to reinforce that one last chart here, this is our wind component breakdown, and you can see it for our climb, or top of descent, and descent phases. And you can see that there for the flight levels from flight level 300 upwards up to 400, there's not much of a temperature drop. Usually we would expect about a 2 degrees centigrade drop per 1,000 feet. For example, if you look at the top of descent chart there, or top of descent column there, from flight level 340 to 420, so that's about 8,000 feet. So 8 times 2 should be 16 degrees of drop static air temperature. But over here we can only see a 4 degree drop, so that's a significantly depressed temperature drop, indicating that that's well into the tropopause section. Okay, so that's it for the briefing. We'll step it up over to the airplane and get her fired up. See you there. Alrighty guys, so there's our airplane. We need to get inside, start setting up, and get ready for the flight. Departure is in approximately 15 minutes, so I need to get a move on over here. So I'm just gonna step inside. I have my head tracking currently enabled, so we'll get this thing so that I can get it set up a little bit faster. Get over to the overhead and rotate all of these switches over to nav. And we'll turn on the yaw damper, the electronic engine controls, engine hydraulic pumps. Actually, you know, I'll just go over to the overhead view and make a static view, which is probably easier for you and me to see. ELT is armed, timer is okay, bus ties, we got the electrical power already established on the airplane, but we don't have the pneumatics currently, so we'll fire up the APU. Okay, APU is coming up. Actually, you know what, we'll turn up the glare shield and everything, all the lighting up there, because cockpit tends to be pretty dark. Emergency lights are going armed, ram air turbine needs to be restowed, engine rev limiter is coming on. What day do we have? Okay, it's an odd day, so we'll start up on starter number one. All of these switches, actually this one can go, both can go to auto, which will just make them currently non-powered. Gonna turn on the window heats, no smoking going to auto, seat belts to auto. Our landing altitude down here is at 0 feet. And we'll put the auto rate controls over here down to center position, or this is usually where the default detent would be. We'll turn up the cabin lighting inside just to get these guys some lights. We can unlock the cockpit door and turn up some lights in here as well. Get the air conditioning all set up, so we'll give them a nice comfy 21 degrees back there. And we'll turn on trim air, turn on the recirculation fans, and also turn on the cabin heat. APU bleed. APU is giving pressure. 48 psi. Also turn on a cross feed so we can open up. We can then feed the engines, although we're going to only be running on one pack for the time being. We don't need to run both of them. It's quite warm enough in here. Okay, going down to the captain's panel here. Just cancel this message. We'll check that all these messages are what we would expect them to be. So all these are looking good for a powered off state. Auto brakes, everything there is looking good. Going to check the engine status. So that we have oil, and what's the hydraulics state? 0.86. I have persistent faults enabled on this airplane, so the airplane will wear out over time as I use it. This is an airplane I use pretty regularly. Do a quick auto land test. Both systems are testing okay. We can close this down. Actually, kind of leave it on. Check brake pressure. We got 3,000 psi in the brake system, so we're not moving anywhere. We got the parking brake engaged anyway, so we're not going anywhere. We can listen to the ATIS, and actually, let me get a pen, and we'll get this thing set up for the flight controls that we have to do, so altitude and headings. Okay, so let's switch over to my flight route, and we'll go ahead and give the ATIS a listen here.
runway assignments, and hold short instructions. All VFR departures, contact clearance delivery with your aircraft type, initial heading, and requested cruise altitude. Operate transponder with mode C on all taxiways and runways. Advise on initial contact you have Mike. Los Angeles International Airport information Mike. 2353 Zulu. Line 250 at 36. Gust 41. Visibility 9 er. Ceiling 2400 broken. 3100 broken. Temperature 13. 2.7. Altimeter 2962. ILS 24 right approach in use. ILS 24 left approach in use. ILS 25 left approach in use. Simultaneous instrument approaches are in progress to runway 24 left 24 right 25 left, and simultaneous approaches are in progress between Los Angeles and Hawthorne airports. Departing runway 24 left. Read back all runway assignments and hold short instructions. All VFR departures, contact.
Okay, so we heard that part already. So we got 2962. That's a fairly low pressure over Los Angeles today, which means we got some severe weather going on, obviously, as we have briefed on the weather briefing ahead of time. So these are set up. Now go over to the first officer's panel, and we'll also set up his altimeter, cross-check it. Actually, we'll do that in a later check. We got pretty significant winds going on, but we'll deal with that as things demand. Okay, so we have Mike, and we need to start setting up the airplane for reals. So let's hop down over to the CDU, go into FMC number 1. We got a current database. It's only February 1st here, first today. So we got a current database and a correct engine type, RB211535E4s. Our current position is KLAX, but we actually need to enter the position of the stand manually because we don't have a gate database. Normally you would just enter the gate over here, but unfortunately Flight Factor 757 does not have a gate database. So we need to enter it manually. I know there we're at gate 64, so that's what we'll key in. We are at North 33. There we go, that's our position initialized. Now, I already have the route stored, so I don't have to key it in manually. KLX KSFO 01 company route load. Activate, execute, and we're good on that. Let's head over here. If you click on this screw over here, that'll bring up the ground chart or the main menu. We need to set up our payload. So we're gonna have 170. Okay, so we have everything over there ready. The jetway is already attached to the plane, as you can see over here. So we can just click over here on ground and tell everybody to start loading the airplane. So we got that cleared up. Let's head down over to the CDU and do the performance initialization. Our zero fuel weight today is going to be 171.9er, so 171,000.9 pounds. Zero fuel weight goes in there. Our reserves, as I look at my release here, it's going to be 7,000. Cost index going to be fairly low, so only 10. Yeah, we're not really worried for time. Cost index is 10. Cruise altitude's 380. Yes, I know. If it gives you that message, you have to come back and re-enter at least one of these pieces of data after you have refueled, because the FMC is too stupid to realize that it's still refueling. We'll head over to our top of climb, and our top of climb is going to be at a wind component. So our top of climb wind is going to be 272/85 knots. ISO deviation today is plus 17, so it's fairly warm, typical for a stormy season. Plus minus 40 degrees, that agrees with our flight plan. Let's head over to the takeoff portion. Actually, I'm going to show you that, how I did that. I have TopCat over here. And TopCat, unfortunately, does not have the Rolls-Royce version of the engines, but at least it has Pratt & Whitney's, which are pretty close, reasonably close enough that we don't really need to worry about being too far off. at least for simulation purposes, obviously. I would not trust it to fly with it in real. Our temperature outside is 13 degrees. Winds today are 250 at pretty significantly 36 knots. Our departure runways at LAX going to be 25 right. Runway condition is, we'll assume that it's dry. And we'll take a flaps 5 departure, and we'll just hit compute and let TopCat calculate all the scenarios. Okay, so our full power departure would leave us 7,600 feet of margin. That's absurdly high. We don't need that. What we can do, actually, is still get 4,500 feet of margin if we derate down at a minimum takeoff performance, so 57 degrees on a flaps 5 departure. So we'll head over here and go to takeoff. We'll take a flaps 5 departure. Usually we would try to select flaps 1, but unfortunately the flight factor of 757 does not allow that. So flaps 5 is what we'll use, 57 degrees on the assumed temperature, so the engines are going to be working significantly less hard, so that'll preserve their life. V1 is going to be 140, V2 is going to be 142, and V2 is going to be 144, so VR is going to be 142. Okay, and that's pretty much it. We'll get the co-pilot side configured over to the Lex page, and we'll get some of the remaining items over here. So I'm going to go over to our pedestal here, and let's just wind this thing down to zero. We'll turn on traffic. Turn on weather over here, even though the weather radar currently is not active. Actually, let's do it like that. Turn on traffic on and weather on his side as well, and I'm going to turn the co-pilot's side up to 40 miles. That's usually what I like to do. Go to the aft pedestal, weather radar is off. Got this radio tune. We've got two radios, and so for proper IFR procedure, we're going to test both of them. So the way we do it is we just ask clearance of the standby radio, or on the second radio, that's what I meant to say. Copilot's going to go listening to the other radio over here. And that's all. I'm pretty happy with that. So let's go over to the frequency page over here on my charts. And we'll talk to clearance, and then we'll talk to ground. And I'll pre-tune tower and departure on the main the left VHF radio. So go down over here. Clearance is going to be 120.35. So 120.35. Actually, let's do it on this radio, as I said. 120.35. Switch that over, and ground to the south is going to be 121.75. Okay, I'm happy with that. Listen to that side.
Climb via SID. You
can see we can already hear the controller.
Expect 330 after 10 minutes. 2141 in the box for Delta 533.
Delta 533,
read pilot.
And I'm going to have one second in position.
Going to talk to these guys in a minute. I know already that they're going to give us an initial climb up to 5,000.
The way how the map is,
so we can set up the MCP over here.
As soon as I can with the...
And departure 5 is going to be heading 250, and we'll brief the departure in a minute. Yeah, as soon as we get there.
Taxi signs out the window that you can see.
So let's. I don't
know. Tower Skyhawk 65831 on short runway 24 on Alpha. For a right crosswind departure.
You know what, let's switch these guys over to
remember
automatic tuning.
Remember 6531, Fullerton Tower, wind 4013, gust 23, runway 24, clear for takeoff, right crosswind departure approved.
24, clear for takeoff, right crosswind departure, 65831.
Plane is loaded. Fantastic. So we'll close the doors. Over here, remove the fuel truck.
But as a 142
and remove the gate configuration. We're still running on the external power. We can do that. Put that away. External GPU can go away, and we are now fully on our own.
Los Angeles ground, November 141.
Crap, ton of chatter on frequency.
November 141, Los Angeles runway 25 right, taxi via Charlie 4 Bravo.
You know what, let's do the departure brief before
Charlie 4 Bravo. for runway 24. And
it's probably going to take a little while to get our word in over here. So let's do the departure brief. We are flying the Ventura 5 departure out of runway 25 right. That's what I expect we'll be given. The Ventura 5 is simply head out on a heading of 250 knots. I'm sorry, 250. You know what, let's jump down over here. Since we are loaded, we can go over back over here to perf. Just re-enter any piece of data over here, and VNAV is going to be happy. Check that we don't have any discos, and we have everything populated. Fantastic. Cool. Now then. Bring that down over here to Lex. So Ventura 5, looking at my chart, I'm going to overlay it on the screen, is 25 right on a heading of 250. That's 249 over here. It's a minimum climb constraint here to 526 feet. Then after passing the 154 radial out of Santa Monica, we'll have to be 3,000 or below. Then we'll split vectors to Ventura and San Marcos, and then we're on our way over to our destination. That's the whole departure. Standard departure procedures apply. Up to 80 knots, we stop for any problems. Above 80 knots, we only stop for engine fire, wind shear or predictive wind shear, or any condition that will deem the airplane unsafe to fly. I will call stop, retard thrust levers, disconnect auto throttle, pull the speed brake up while applying full braking, and then reverse. Meanwhile, the first officer would lower the flaps in case we need to evacuate the airplane, but we'll stop on the runway and we'll assess what we need to do. If possible, we'll vacate as soon as possible and circle around to figure out what's happening. If we have to take the airplane into the air and the problem above V1, we will need to take the problem into the air. We'll make left traffic. We'll continue up up to 1,000 feet with no actions. After that, we'll clean up the airplane, accelerate up to minimum clean speed, and try to fly the heading still on the departure, and we'll coordinate with ATC any sort of corrective actions that need to be taken. Right, so that's the departure brief complete. Actually, one more thing. I'm going to overlay the ground chart and inform you guys about the taxi we'll be doing. We are currently positioned at Terminal 6, which will be on, we'll be pushing back onto Concourse Charlie 7, then over out of Charlie 7, probably getting Bravo, and we'll taxi back down to the approach end of runway 25 right, and then a departure straight into the wind, which would be which is pretty much blowing straight into our face out of heading 250. Okay, so that's the taxi brief complete as well. We'll get the clearance and get the show up on the road. One more thing, I need to connect my ACARS thingy here, because I'm doing this for United Virtual. And there we go. Now we'll talk to clearance and get this thing set up. Los Angeles clearance, good afternoon. United 480 IFR to San Francisco, please.
United 480 Los Angeles delivery, good afternoon. Clear to San Francisco International Airport, Ventura 5 departure, San Marcos transition. Then as filed. Climb via the SID, accept maintain 5000. Expect flight level 380, 10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 125.2, squawk 6401.
Clear to San Francisco via Ventura 5 departure, San Marcos transition, Dennis file, climb via the SID, accept maintain 5000, 380 after 10, departure 125.2, squawk 6401, United 480.
United 480, read back right. Assessment of 9 Tango Charlie, contact departure.
They've been doing this flight quite frequently so far, so I already am fairly familiar with the clearance that we're going to get here, so we need to set in our squawk 6401, that's set up. Departure frequency, we'll set that up over here. Our tower to the south of the field. Tower is 120.95, so this just scrolls up to 95. Departure is going to be 125.2. I'm doing this pre-tuning over here so that I don't have to fuddle about with it during climbing, because I'm going to get the hands over pretty
quickly.
Yuma
Tower, Sierra 612, Sierra Romeo, only short... runway
okay,
two
let's
one,
switch back over to clearance. Actually, we can go away from clearance and head over to ground. 6401 is set up.
Number 612, Sierra Romeo.
Departure.
Taxi via runway
clearance.
17, cross runway 21 right and runway 21 left.
Yeah, well,
and
we'll
join Echo
make
northbound.
You shut up for a while longer.
Okay, we're going to go ahead
and we're going to bring up our checklist and do the pre-flight checklist. Pre-flight checklist. Oxygen, well, I'll say it was checked. Pressurization mode selector is set to auto. Flight instruments, heading 252, altimeter 2962, reading 140 just below, 2962 just below 140. And on the co-pilot side, we got 2962 reading just below 140, heading 252. Flight instruments have been checked. Parking brake is set. Fuel control switches are cut off and gear pins have been removed. Pre-flight checklist is complete. Now, what's next on the agenda? We have checked that we have the fuel. Actually, one more thing. Got 17.1. Seatbelts are auto. Everything else is here looking pretty well and happy. So I'm pretty satisfied. We can start to push back in just a second. We'll bring up this screen over here. This goes over to initial reference, which is where it needs to be for departure. And yeah, we'll switch this guy over to TARA. Actually, we'll do a quick trick here. I'll just cycle the parking brake. And that'll get the gate to move away. And let's turn on the light over here. Hop down, do the pushback request. Ground chocks are going away. I need to do a manual pushback here because we are fairly close in the alleyway here and I don't want to rely on some other pushback mechanism. Okay, now let's do the before start checklist, then we'll start pushing back. So fuel has been checked, 17.1, that's correct. Passenger signs are set, windows are locked, MCP is 144V2, 250 on a heading, 5,000 is the initial climb, that's all set. Takeoff thrust derate 57 degrees to 1.56 on both engines. Takeoff speeds are checked. CDO pre-flight is completed. Rudder trim is zero and aileron trim. Actually, there should be an indication here, but I know it's zero. Both zero taxi and takeoff briefing is completed. Flight deck door needs to be locked, which I forgot to do. So there we go. And the red anti-collision light is on. Before start checklist is complete. Now let's do the before start procedure. So we'll head over here to the overhead, turn that off, fire up the fuel pumps, fire up the hydraulics. The order over here on the hydraulics is important. So this one, then C1, C2 electric, and then left electric. Okay, I'm gonna hop over here to the pushback view. Parking brake is coming off, and we'll start the pushback. There's a little truck down here. This is just my view that I'm using over here. I can't start the engines while I'm pushing back. That's a limitation on the built-in pushback from the flight factor model. But at least you can enjoy the view. How late are we? Not too late, about 5 minutes. Gonna speed up pushback a little bit. Obviously now, if we were in a real airplane, using the automatic pushback, we could already start starting the engines. But here on Los Angeles, as you can see, the gates are really close together, so they really don't want you to start engines until you are completely aligned with this center line over here. Okie doke. You know what, we'll pull it forwards a little bit. So we'll go to pull forward. Rotate my view around, and we'll pull the airplane a little bit ahead just to make sure that we're quite clear of that wall back there. I know it's a blast wall and it's supposed to be able to take it, but I don't want the blast deflecting all over the place, which would really just be bad karma. Jet engines do have a pretty significant amount of jet blast, and yeah, they will blow things around if you are not careful. It's actually been accidents because of that. Okie doke. We are stopped, and pushback is dismissed. The pushback truck will now come out of from under the aircraft. And we will wait until it's clear. I'll turn on my head tracking. And there they go. Okay, everything clear. You know what, we'll play the
November 141, British, you're taxiing the wrong direction on Bravo. Make the right turn at Charlie 5.
You are mighty annoying. Okay. Now, startup sequence number 1, then number 2, which is standard at United. We have fuel, so started going down the ground. We'll wait for, minimum should be 25% on N2 and N3. But I will wait a little bit longer because this airplane does have a propensity for a hot start. So it will probably about 28 to 29%. Come on, baby. Starting pressure is, well, still about 10 PSI over. So, yeah, 27, 28, and fuel number 1 is coming in. One more thing, I wanted to start my timer over here when I started pushback, which I did not do. And I have a starter timer on my yoke to time engine or starter cutout. Alright, we have starter cutout and I'm looking at my yoke, which is 16 seconds. That's pretty good. Number 2 going to ground. You obviously want to have, the reason why I'm turning off the packs here before start is obviously because otherwise we wouldn't have sufficient starting pressure in the duct and we'd not be able to spin up the engines up to 25 or minimum 25%. Okay, 28, I'm happy with that. I'll feed the fuel in, watch the EGTs. And EGT has peaked. We have oil temperature, I'm sorry, UF oil pressure is good. And 17 seconds on this engine start. I'm happy with that. After start items, which would normally be done by the first officer. But unfortunately, the first officer is taking a break today. Engines are good. Everything else over here is looking pretty well. We're up to flight director, auto throttle, right flight director. Flight controls check. Full forward. This would normally be done in parallel by the captain and the first officer. The first officer would be setting up the systems and the captain would be doing flight controls checks. But obviously I'm alone here today, so I'm gonna have to do everything myself. Okay, weather radar going to turbulence because we expect turbulence today and we need to set our departure flaps. So flaps 5. Auto brake is RTO, and we can do the before taxi checks. Alright, so it wants us to cycle. Actually, well, we might need to turn on the anti-ice for the departure, but we'll see that. We have icing reported over flight level 80 up to 120. Okay, anti-ice was checked, isolation valve is off. Recall was checked. Auto brake RTO. Ground equipment is clear. We are cleared. I'm sorry. We are complete on the taxi. Let's arm LNAV and VNAV. And we'll give ground a call. So ground is on 0.75.
Hey, Blue Ridge 1250 is clear to Lachlan Airport on a border 7. Julianne transition as filed, 8,000 initial. Expect flight level 230 and 10, 19.6 and 2107.
Blue Ridge 1250, read back, right?
Blue Ridge 1250.
Los Angeles ground, United 480, taxi with Mike.
United 480, Los Angeles ground, runway 25 right, taxi via Charlie, Charlie 1 Bravo.
Charlie, Charlie 1 Bravo, to holding short, 25 right, United 480. Okay, we are good over there.
Los
turn
Angeles
on the taxi
November
light,
with you
center my view. I'm
going to
turn on my tracking here because I need that. And clear left and right. Parking brake is coming off. And
November 141,
start the taxi.
Yeah, you're about 3/4 of a mile from the end of the runway. I'm unable to issue the I-6 as a pass, as you did enter an active runway without clearance. Say your intentions.
Okay. Charlie, Charlie 1. Check our head, check our directions over here. So left clear, right side is clear. Slow down just a touch to get over this turn here.
November 141, Los Angeles ground, did you copy?
Somebody didn't pass their instrument exams. That sucks each and every time. Okay, so reviewing the departure here, just gonna stick my head like that. Ventura 5, so heading 250 up to 5,000 vectors. Other than that, we have nothing to worry about. We need to check we have. Okay, clear left and right. I'm gonna switch this over. We have departure pre-tuned in the standby position on that on the left radio, so we should be pretty good there. And that's pretty much it. We'll give the cabin a bit of a bong here. So, beam 1, beam 2, beam 3.
Long Beach clearance delivery, Delta 1357 with information whiskey.
There's Charlie 4.
IFR clearance to Las Vegas on request.
Delta 1357, Long Beach clearance delivery, clearance on request.
Right side clear.
Van Nuys Tower, Skyhawk 65831. Is east of
this
the airport.
Charlie 3.
Bound for landing. No
yep.
Information, no ATIS.
November 65831, Van Nuys Tower. Wind 01017, gust 23, visibility 10, light rain. Ceiling 2300, broken. Temperature 8, 2.4, altimeter 2961. Enter right base, runway 16 right.
Right base for 65831.
Just a beautiful scenery from after X06.
November
six
on
right.
The visual, 2-9er clear.
Looks
six
pretty,
right,
pretty
six
stunning.
Five,
I gotta give it to the guy. Okay, Cessna,
six, five, eight,
does know
nine,
how to
sorry,
make good scenery.
And a right base runway 3-4 right.
Okay, here's Charlie 2. Left
three,
side is clear.
Right,
next
six,
one's gonna
five,
be Charlie 1. We're going to turn over
calling,
to the right.
Duke 626 November on the visual 2-9er.
Duke 626 November, St. Louis Tower, wind 2-9-0 with 2-3, gust 3-3, runway 2-9.
They do expect us to switch over to tower
Glenn,
ourselves.
Glenn, 2-9-66 November.
Santa Monica ground, Cessna on Juliet Golf.
Which is normally in the
south.
U.S., that's
west
what we
ramp.
Do.
Taxi 2-1, we got information unicorn.
Here's Charlie 1. To the right. Yep.
Aircraft calling Sega.
Slow down a little bit. Maximum text, maximum
Cessna
10
one,
knots.
Juliet Golf, Santa
through
Monica
turns,
ramp.
Anything exceeding high speed.
The southwest ramp. Mike, taxi to 2-1, information uniform.
Number 1, Juliet Golf, Santa Monica ground, runway 2-1, taxi via Bravo.
Right, clear.
Okay, Bravo down 2-1, one Juliet Golf, thanks.
And left side clear. Yeah, right side is clear.
The Palm Springs Tower, Cessna 985.
Contact
Golf,
over there above
right.
The field.
November 9853, Palm Springs Tower, wind 1308, runway 13 right, clear to land.
Clear to land, 13 right, 9853 Golf.
Okay, and we'll talk to tower now. So let's just simply switch it over, and now, there we go, we're on tower. Los Angeles Tower, United 480, short of 25 right, ready for departure.
United 480, Los Angeles Tower, wind 25036, gust 41, right, 25 right, clear for takeoff.
25 right, clear for takeoff, United 480. Yep, they confirmed wind check, it's pretty bad. So, lights, everything coming on.
Number clearance,
taxi light is coming
taxi,
off.
Tango.
And we need to do the before takeoff.
Blue Ridge 1250, Lindbergh ground, runway 27, taxi via Bravo.
Takeoff briefing was reviewed, packs are on, flaps are set, 5, stab trim, which is something I always forget, I forgot to set again. Approach sector is clear, and the runway is clear. There we go, 3.8 units is what we usually set here. Stab trim is set, flight control has been checked, and cabin is secure before takeoff. Checklist is complete. Line up procedure
St. Louis
is Wayne, completed.
2903, gust 33.
Thank you.
Gonna turn off my head tracking here. We are lined up. First flight of the day,
Cessna
so we'll 6581, run up.
Wind 01017, gust 23, runway 34 right, clear to land.
Right, clear to land.
Engines are stable. APR engaged. APR coming up. Thrust is set. 1.56, 80 knots. Thrust hold.
San Francisco ground, Delta 533, gate 25. We have Bravo ready for taxi.
Delta 531,
rotate.
Runway 1 left, taxi via Alpha, Mike 1.
1 left, yeah, Alpha, Mike 1 for Delta 533.
Rotate in a nice, smooth fashion. Got positive rate gears coming up. Now we're immediately in the turbulence. A little bit.
Delta 533, wind 30032, gust 39er. Are you able, runway 1 left?
Okay, 1,000 feet.
Repeat winds.
And turn
for,
on the autopilot because my workload's
3003, correction, 30032, gusting 39er.
We'll take 28 if you could. Either of those would do.
Delta 533, runway 28 left, taxi via Alpha Hotel Bravo Foxtrot. Hold short,
TIs
runway 1 left.
Is on. You can turn these guys off.
Okay, 28 left via Alpha Hotel Bravo Foxtrot. Hold short,
flaps
1
up.
Left for Delta 533.
Delta 533, my taxi instructions is pick it at runway 28 left, taxi via
and
Alpha
I expect
Hotel
a handoff
Bravo
to departure
Foxtrot
in a
1.
Second here.
Hold short, runway 1 left.
After taking
28 left
checklist.
Via Alpha Hotel Bravo Foxtrot 1.
Altimeters are still
short,
set. We transition at 18,000 feet. After takeoff checklist is complete. Past Santa Monica, so climbing 5,000.
Santa Monica Tower, Snow 1 Juliet Golf, ready to go. 2-1.
Coming up to 5,000.
Number 1 Juliet Golf, Santa Monica Tower.
We'll do
wind 24014, gust 2-1, runway 2-1, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, Cessna 1 Juliet Golf.
United 480, contact departure.
Over to departure, United 480. SoCal departure, United 480, 5,000. 125.2 was... Yep, that's the right frequency. SoCal departure, United 480, 5000.
United 480, SoCal departure, radar contact, climb maintain 13, 13,000.
Climb maintain 13,000, United 480. Okay, so the controller was a little late, but no matter. Re-engage VNAV, new limitation up to 13,000. That'll put us hopefully above most of this stuff over here. And let's get out of this turbulence as fast as we can.
If it doesn't work, come back to me and I can give you a taxi.
Yeah, we'll get the seatbelt set up. Remain on. Just make sure nobody's standing up because turbulence is expected to be fairly up there. Yep, 30 knots of headwind. And that's just the static component, I'm sorry, the constant component. The gusts are, as you can see, we're gusting easily 20 miles.
250 on the heading.
Air 1, Juliet Golf, SoCal departure, radar contact, climb maintain.
That's with the airplane giving it the best in trying to control.
United 480, contact Los Angeles, center 135.5, have a good day.
Center on 355, United 480, see ya. Los Angeles Center, United 480 passing 10,304 on 3000.
United 480, LA Center, proceed direct. San Marcos VOR, is in wind navigation, climb maintain flight level 230.
Direct San Marcos for zone on nav, climb maintain flight level 230, United 480.
There, Niner Tango Charlie, did you call
quite
back
a mouthful. So direct San Marcos, there we go, climb maintain 13230. And, shakiness has stopped. We'll give it a little bit more time and we'll see if the weather is going to remain. Well, I forgot my timing again for departure. Always. Always myself. Don't worry about me forgetting to do stuff. Okay, 12,000, so 12,000 feet. We'll leave the landing lights on. That's policy at United. Up to 18,000. After that, we'll turn them on together with the transition altitude.
The other aircraft that called up, say call sign request. 5x5.
And that's pretty much it. We'll switch over the co-pilot's CDU over to Progress, which is where I like to keep it. About 80 miles at the top of descent. We'll have only about 80 miles in the cruise, and then straight down at descent.
As filed, maintain 6,000. Expect 9,000 flash
parts. Next frequency I know already is going to be 133.55.
Squawk 5501. Hold for release and advise of your proposed departure time and your read back, please.
Somebody's departing out of an uncontrolled airfield, so that's why this is the kind of strange clearance they gave us. One interesting tidbit might interest you guys is when they gave us climb via the SID on our departure clearance. Our departure clearance said departure is going to be Ventura 5, departure, San Marcos transition.
Departure clearance voided not by 01.
Then as filed, that means that whatever we had filed up until the transition is overridden, but fortunately he just repeated whatever we already had in the departure. Then he said climb via the SID, set maintain 5,000. Climb via the SID to 7,185,000 means that you are authorized to climb, but you have to comply with all altitude restrictions and procedural restrictions on your departure up until reaching 5,000, after which you cannot climb any further. So basically that enforces the Santa Monica limitation, which we had, which I showed you over on our departure on the legs page, which said that up until the 154 radial out of Santa Monica, we're limited to 3,000 or below, and the aircraft complied with that.
Turn right heading 050.
So this climb via the SID basically just means keep that constraint and stop your climb at 5,000.
Contact Los Angeles Center 133.55. Have a good day.
3355 United 480 CO. Los Angeles Center, United 480, passing flight level 210 for 230.
United 480, LA Center, climb maintain flight level 380.
Climb maintain 380, United 480.
November 1, Juliet
there we go.
Golf, turn
and that's the
right.
Whole departure completed.
Heading
nothing too dramatic.
70.
If you get into the rhythm of it.
264 was in wind navigation.
Okay, so we'll cut the video here. The rest of the flight is going to be an uneventful climb, and I'll pick it up as we are about to start the descent. Okay, it's got 40 miles up to top of descent. Start the arrival brief. Surfer 2 RNAV arrival. Let's bring this guy up. Surfer 2 RNAV starts at Surfer, which we have, which is our next point. We'll actually start descending ahead of that. Then at Nerley, 280 or above at 280 knots. Then waves
NKX right contact
between 15,000 and 190, 280 knots. So we got 190 planned there. Then Epic, 280 at 15, between 10 and 15,000. Then Eddy, 6,000 or above, 240 knots.
Number 738 NKX ray, SoCal departure.
Swells 4,700. Let's bring that over here. Swells at 4,700 feet or above, and then Menlo, 4,000 or above, at 230
call
knots.
Is what
the departure. Well, the departure has, but I've already programmed in an approach. It's the ILS 28 left.
Or 2809 kilo. Cancel taxi instructions
at Menlo.
And call me back.
We're going to be a couple of more amendments here. I want to be at Menlo. Actually, we want to go swells. We want to be 230 knots. So this airplane is super slippery. If we fly in 240 up until
Menlo,
and then
contact
Hemo.
LA Center.
So she's already on the
right
on the approach. Course, we're gonna just be having trouble slowing down. Have to use speed brake, which is kind of bad.
November 1 Juliet Golf, contact LA Center 126.35.
So we'll use, we'll get to Menlo at 210 knots. We'll slow down a little bit ahead of that. We'll start the approach like that. So the approach briefing for ILS 28 left. We are gonna have
November 1 Juliet Golf,
the plate
LA Center.
The plate is out of August 13, 2015. So we have a current plate. ILS frequency
number
is 109
or 0.55.
Front course is 284. Front course set. We'll listen to the ATIS in a second here, but that's what we'll be given most likely. Approach starts at Menlo, 4,000 or above. Then Heman. Then Duyet. Then there's the runway. At Heman. It'll be 3,100 or above. That's correct.
Number 1 Juliet Golf,
then we'll
Los Angeles Center.
Intercept the glide slope at about 11.5 miles out. Duyet, 1,800. Nepic, which is a point not charted over
and
here,
transit.
Is 1,080. That's a cross check for
transit
our position.
Transit 1 Juliet Golf, mid altitude again.
Altitude.
Make it 14,000
left. Missed approach. Climb straight up. 284. Up to 420 minimum. Then direct Alam, climbing to 4,000 feet. At Alam, we're going to hold on
to maintain 13,000.
So basically, we'll just fly straight up ahead and hold over Alam on a 275 track.
Thermer 738 Yankee Alam. X-ray, fly heading 360, join Victor 8, resume on navigation, climb maintain 5,000.
All right, that's all set. I'll listen to the ATIS. Head over here, refresh. Go to SFO and listen.
San Francisco International Airport Information Charlie.
Blue Ridge 1250, contact LA Center 125.65.
9290 at 23. Gust 33. Visibility 10. Few clouds at 4,000. Few clouds at 7,000. 15,000 scattered.
Blue Ridge 1250, your outside is a slant alpha. Fly heading 010 whenever direct thermal.
Altimeter 2980. Tiptoe visual approach runway 28 left in use. Quiet bridge visual approach runway 28 right in use. Departing runway 1 left. 1 right. Read back all runway assignments, and hold short instructions. All VFR departures, contact clearance delivery with your aircraft type, initial heading, and requested cruise altitude. Operate transponder with mode C on all taxiways
and
runways.
United 40, contact Oakland Center 133.7.
Open center on 337, United 480. And they're also going to give us a clearance to descend, so we need to talk to them. Open center, United 480, flight level 380.
United 480, Oakland Center, roger.
Why are you slowing down?
Delta 1357, right, contact Oakland, contact Los Angeles, right, Center 125.
Wind
165.
Is slowing down, so the airplane has to do a little bit of catch up here. Because we're leaving the jet stream before that we were.
Delta 1357, contact LA Center 125.65.
Okay, so we have Charlie, Windis 29023, gust 33, so it's going to be an interesting landing.
Romeo, contact.
Fortunately, it's aligned with the runway 10 miles visibility, few 4,000, few 8, scattered 15,000, 298 in on the altimeter. That's the important part. Going to get over and also brief the tiptoe visual.
Oxnard ground, runway 25, taxi via Foxtrot Alpha.
So the tiptoe visual from 13 August 2015, starting at Menlo 5,000, heading 331. 14 miles, Oakland VOR, heading 310 to intercept the localizer inbound on 284.
Number 612 Sierra Romeo, thanks for Victor.
Then
the
straight in approach at distance 6 SFO, minimum 1,800, that's across the San Mateo Bridge.
Right.
And then straight into the runway.
Fowler 21, SoCal. Fowler 21, Mr. Check-in back. Contact SoCal Approach 119.6.
One thing, I wanted to set up the minimums for the ILS, which is 200 feet.
Delta 1357, contact LA Center 125.65.
And that's pretty much it. Minus 34 degrees.
Delta 1357, LA Center, climb maintain flight level 230.
Now, how far are we from top of descent? About 20 miles. It's pretty good. Check the recall.
21 SoCal approach. The
field altitude is 0.
Expect vectors localizer on 27.
That was checked. We briefed the tiptoe, which is pretty much the same thing as the ILS. Actually, Menlo is at 5,000 on the tiptoe, so noted. 2,500 at distance 10 from SFO, 1,800 at distance 6. We're pretty much just following the light slope out. Since we'll be navigating visually, we're going to be doing that. We'll read the remarks. When visual approaches on runway 2 at left, right in progress, rocking aircraft, maybe vectors into a position for a straight in visual approach from runway 2 at left, right at ISFO localizer. Aircraft should cross radial 151, distance 16.1 from Oakland and or Menlo at or above 5,000 and San Mateo Bridge at or above 1,800. Is that a weather refresh, I think?
United 480, send via the surfer 2 arrival, landing west, the San Francisco altimeter 2980.
Descend via Surfer 2 arrival, landing west 2988 on the altimeter, United 480.
United 480, San Francisco altimeter 2980.
Sorry, 2980 on the altimeter, United 480. Good thing you checked me.
Aircraft
okay.
Second.
Aircraft is now screaming at me that it wants to reset the MCP altitude, so we'll do that. Because we've already reached top of descent and we have not done that yet, so we'll go over here and start the descent now.
System 2809 kilo, Oxnard Tower, wind 28035, gust 45, runway 25, clear for takeoff.
And we'll give it back its speed
controls. System 8 Yankee X-ray, climb maintained 5,000.
We have checked recall.
System 8 Yankee X-ray, traffic. 2 o'clock,
everything else, so we can do the descent checklists now. Head over to the checklist. Pressurization was checked, recall was checked, auto brake is going to be level 2. One more thing on the landing data, which I always forget. Yeah, VRF's 130. Our headwinds are going to be about 23 knots, 10 knots extra. Half of that, we'll probably be approaching at about 145-ish.
Remember, so we're going to have across the Keiko at or above 9,500, cleared RNAV.
Fairly high amount of headwinds
the
there. Sorry, a fairly high amount of excess speed. Our policy at United is half the steady wind component, which would be 137 plus the whole excess, 147, with 2 months, 145 is going to be our approach speed. That will give us a sufficient buffer for landing. And landing data was checked, yeah. 10955, 284. Front course is checked and approach briefing was completed. Descent checklist is complete. I set the altitude restriction down at a minimum descent, which will be 3,100 for the initial portion of the ILS approach. That's what I'm sticking with for the moment. That's what.
Pilot 21, fly heading 080 vectors, localizer runway 27 approach. Pilot 21, descend and maintain 5,000.
Now the FMS here is a little bit unhappy with us.
0 Romeo, fly heading 220. Descent and maintain 3,000.
And then it thinks we're 1,760 feet above our projected descent path. Well, not worry about that for now. We'll catch up with that a little bit later without any trouble. So we'll take care of that. Surfer. Now right turn over to Nerley. Let's hope I'll stick the landing somehow usably. It's not going to be a soft landing by any means with those gusts, with 10 knots gusted. Excess on the gusts. It's not going to be a very pretty landing. I admit that.
Contact early center
right away.
5.27.
But I'm going to try and make it reasonably soft. I get still things that work too fast. Oh, there we go. Didn't even need to do anything. Now it thinks we're on profile. Oh, this flight factor, flight management system is super quirky and frankly it's kind of crap, but you gotta live with it. Learn and work with it. Sunset over the sea over there. I'm gonna go into an evening Los Angeles. And actually, I'm going to go straight up and turn around and fly the route straight back.
Delta 1357, Rogers. November 1, Juliet Golf. Radar service terminated. Report IFR cancellation on the ground this frequency.
Nearly going to be 200 or above.
November 1, Juliet Golf. No traffic observed between you and the Big Bear Airport. Delta 1357, do you have a different altitude on request? November 612 Sierra Romeo, fly heading 320.
Let's turn these up a little bit.
Pilot 21, fly heading 090. Route 21 descend and maintain 4,000.
Usually, when coming over here into into San Francisco, we don't actually get much of vectors. We just get the full procedure because vectors would not even give us any kind of shortcut. Actually, X-Plane has decided to start rendering some airport lights over there. I don't know what those are because the field is still quite a ways away.
Remember, 2809 Halo Point Magro Perch standby.
It's about 80 miles away.
Sirius 20 Romeo, fly heading 360.
Might be some other airport. Actually, let's bring that up. Can bring up the airports. Where are you? There you are. Ah, Montgomery Field, KMRY. So that's the thing we're seeing there. And there's another field over here. It's not showing up. And there's San Jose. That I don't know what that would be. Oakland, and then there over there is San Francisco.
Number 612 here, Romeo. I think I'm gonna be able to get you down.
Over there,
the
there's Santa
expect
Monica.
Expect localizer runway, or correction, expect localizer delta approach.
I'm sorry. Yeah, Sacramento, not Santa Monica.
Sirius 2 Sierra Romeo, this will be a vector through the localizer, or vector across the localizer for your descent.
Montgomery Field, I got some new scenery for that recently.
Cessna Yankee X-ray, contact SoCal approach 135.4.
From explain.org, from wonderful explain.
United 480, contact NorCal approach 127.15.
127.15, United 480. There we go, NorCal approach, and we need to give them that we have
Valor 215 heading 180.
So we do have Charlie on board. NorCal approach, United 480, passing 240 on the surfer 2 arrival, descending with the arrival Charlie information.
United 480, NorCal approach, Roger, San Francisco altimeter 2980.
2980, United 480.
November 738, Yankee X-ray, SoCal approach. Ontario,
so he's not giving me the
63.
Expected approach yet, so we'll need to repeat that we have information Charlie, the next controller, as well. There's two layers of NorCal over here in Northern California when you're approaching San Francisco. It's just the same as two layers of...
Valor 215, miles from O'Kane, fly heading
two layers of center.
Zero.
Back over in LA.
Fly heading 240, maintain 3,800 till established on localizer. Cleared ILS, correction cleared, localizer runway 27 approach.
Two niner, niner two currently. We'll transition over
Valor
to...
Valor 2-1, maintain 3,800 until establishing a localizer. November 612 Sierra Romeo, turn left turn, heading 210.
Our information, the latest info we had was from... let's see, actually, let's listen to it again. Normally, obviously, you'd be tuning
San
this on
Francisco
your radio.
San Francisco International Airport information, Charlie. 0056 Blue.
0056, so the information is about 40 minutes old.
Cessna, Cessna 8,
oh, we're
going to
be landing
Park
before
Paradise, BOR, heading
the
060
next
Vectors,
info cycle comes out, which is
approach.
Hourly. Waves constrained is going to be hard constrained 190.
Prowler 21, fly heading 240 to intercept localizer. Cessna 8 Yankee X-ray, depart Paradise VOR, heading 060 Vectors, ILS runway 26 left approach.
Where's that? I don't know. Wasn't listening. As you can see, the green banana is indicating that we'll reach 3,100, our pre-selected MCP altitude, at approximately when we're about to cross He-Man. Which is exactly what we expect for our arrival over here. He-Man 3,100 or above. He-Man is over here. And the banana is crossing over He-Man over there, so we do expect that our descent profile will take us there exactly right. Problem is the flight factor FMS, again, has a bug where it does not calculate your the requirement to slow down below 250 at 10,000 feet, so... We'll actually have to use speed brake to recompensate for that.
Los Angeles, Santa Roger.
Yep, 9.2 at SFO. Our fuel is 10.2 currently. Minus 20 degrees is already warming up because we're descending down. We're 197. Flight level 197. Total air temp is minus 10. As you can see, the fuel tanks are lagging behind quite a bit. So about fuel tanks are currently about 10 degrees colder than the total air temperature. What's the static air temperature, by the way? Minus 26. Yeah. As we are slowing down and going down lower into the atmosphere, obviously the static air temperature and the total air temperature is going to be going to start to come closer together.
Tower 118.3.
It's just simply a feature of us slowing down. The slower you are,
November
the closer your total air temperature.
From Samos, fly heading 240.
It's to the static air temperature. Total air temperature is simply
clear,
static air temperature plus any kind of ram rise you have from moving fast through the air. That's simply a function of the Mach number. Essentially, you can think about the difference between total air and the static air temperature if you understand how temperature works. If you think about it the right way, temperature, actually coming up on transition altitude over here, 2980. Turn on the landing lights as per airline policy.
Lyrics
1250, as well over here, 17,400 reading now. Good. So we have that.
Delta 1350, cross Clarat, maintain 13 13,000, Las Vegas altimeter 29035.
So total air temperature and static air temperature is essentially, if you think about temperature as the average kinetic energy,
Valor 21, Berg Tower,
speed,
wind 28026, gust 34, runway 27.
Simply speaking, the speed at which molecules are moving, that's what you measure with your temperature. And since you are moving through the air, essentially what you're doing, your,
Clarat, maintain 13,
your movement basically imparts relative to your motion to these molecules a higher apparent speed. So that's basically your gram rise. You can measure it using a standard thermometer. If you first bring the air to a stop, that means
Romeo contact Gillespie Tower.
That means that basically the movement, the relative motion of the atoms relative to your thermometer, then needs to translate into, once you stop the whole packet of air, the molecules individually still want to go fast. So what they do is basically they appreciate the temperature. That's what your thermometer measures. It measures the basically the average speed of the molecules whizzing around in the gas.
6120 Romeo Gillespie Tower, wind 25016, gust 25 runway. Fly straight in, runway 27 right, runway 27 right, clear to land.
Okay, approaching Epic. Epic's going to be at 15,000. And we're actually going to undershoot it. Wonderful. Real good job you're doing there. Flight management system, but it actually knows it's only printing 15,000, but it. We can pass Epic at between 10 and 15,000. So simply being under it is okay.
Yeah, I know you called me a little bit a little earlier. Say again, request.
Explains fantastic night lighting coming into view over here. Take a look down here. This is the Greater Bay Area.
System 09 Kilo, squawk 4601.
It's starting to light up. Actually, this is the Pacific Ocean. Bay Area starts roughly right over there-ish. Obviously, I have the render distance set so that I'm still able to get at least some sort of reasonable FPS out of this thing. As you can see, it's actually even rendering individual cars down there. Which is why I think X-Plane at night looks absolutely
breathtaking. Number 1, Juliet, call. My car cancellation was received. It's our pleasure. You have a good night.
Parking at the gate's going to be in Fox 90. Gonna flash the ground chart here on the screen quickly. We'll roll in on runway 28 left.
29 kilo radar contact 20
we'll vacate
miles
probably
Santa
either
Barbara
over
airport
on
contact
Juliet
Santa Barbara approach 0.55.
Or possibly take it down to Tango, and we'll roll down to Fox 90, Foxtrot 90, which is
120.55.
Terminal 3 and of the Foxtrot gates. It's basically on the tip of Terminal 3. That's a domestic gate that's frequently used by United. It'll work for us just fine. Got a bogey over here. Some VFR contact. Not showing up on my... It's not showing up on TCAS, so it's probably quite a bit away still.
Kinger 221 Bravo Echo, Bullhead Colors.
Approaching 10,000. 10,000 feet. Normally, for many airlines, this is when they would turn on their landing lights. At United, as before mentioned, we're turning on our landing lights at transition level. As per company policy.
King Air 221 Bravo Echo, I don't have a flight plan for you.
Gonna have to use
I don't have
speed
a November
here
in front of your call sign. That could be it. Log back into the network with November 221 Bravo Echo, please. Valor 21, contact our 123.9er.
Expect the hands off here pretty soon to NorCal approach lower. That'll give us a drag required.
Cessna 8 Yankee X-ray, fly heading 340.
That's the FMS complaining. As you can see, the vertical profile is running away from us, so that means that the FMS did not anticipate the deceleration phase here.
Delta 533, descent pilot discretion, maintain flyable 240. Delta 533, disregard.
Okay, speed brake coming in.
American 178,000. Runway 19 or left, taxi via Charlie Golf Delta. Thanks for your patience.
I'm sorry that I put up another 757 video that's at night here. I did not anticipate that. Originally, I wanted this to be during the evening, but I'm flying in real time, and that's what the time of day is here. So, that's what we get. The actual real flight for United, this 480 actually happens at an even later
time.
System
2809 Kilo, Santa Barbara, approach Santa Barbara, altimeter 2976.
We've got some pretty night lighting. This is the Greater Bay Area.
Ground, taxi to parking.
This is, I think,
Bravo,
San Jose.
Bravo 4, hold short, runway 27.
And some other airports lighting up over there. San Francisco is right around there-ish somewhere.
Okay.
Got a little bit of turbulence.
Okay, I had two reading the back. 09er Kilo, you're in the air. You shouldn't be reading back taxi instructions.
Yeah,
that was for
I
another
forgot
aircraft.
To turn on the fasten seatbelt signs, but fortunately we're still got a little bit way to go to start actually any turns. But we're coming up on turbulence here, so fortunately that reminded me. Otherwise, we would have landed with seatbelt signs.
1250 contact LA Center, 124.2. Delta 1357 contact, Las Vegas approach, 125.0.
I don't think he has given me an approach clearance yet. So I'm going to be asking him about that. Switch this thing over to legs.
Clear 1250, Los Angeles Center. Descend and maintain 900,000. Expect VOR. What was their request? Clear 1250, expect VOR 3-4 approach.
Norcal approach unit 480 with an approach request, please.
Okay, I had like five aircraft talking at once there. November 738, Yankee X-ray, turn left heading 230.
Okay, slowing down now.
Delta 1357, Las Vegas approach. Expect ILS runway 25 left approach, Las Vegas altimeter 2935.
Pre-tuned tower now in here, 120.5.
Delta 1357, head course.
And into the second radio, we'll tune ground, which is 0.8.
Number 612 Sierra Romeo, contact ground 121.7.
Actually, we'll switch that over into active. There we go.
Rather 21 at Bravo 6 cross runway 27, taxi parking via Charlie, monitor ground.
Frame rate's taking a dip. Or a dump. NorCal approach, United 480. If I'm not mistaken, you have given us an approach clearance yet.
United 480, contact NorCal approach, 133.95.
133.95, United 480. Fantastic, he forgot about me. This usually doesn't happen on Pilot Edge. NorCal approach, United 480, passing 5,700, Surfer 2 with Charlie.
United 480, NorCal approach, cross Menlo at or above 4,000, cleared ILS, right 28 left approach.
Menlo at or above 4,000, cleared ILS, 28 left approach, United 480.
November 738,
so
X-ray.
What we have planned has come to pass.
4,000 until 7,000.
My radios over here. Okay, we have everything planned here as we should. We'll do the checklist. Altimeters have been checked. Navigators are checked. Approach checklist is complete. Airplane
American
is fully configured. You know, we'll throw out flaps one for now.
Up to 1357. Descend and maintain 8,000.
Give it a little bit of speed break because we're above profile. Menlo is at above at or above 4,000. little bit higher speed, so we start the descent.
Delta 1250, fly Miles present, heading vectors for your descent.
Localizer is alive.
Correction, Blue Ridge 1250, fly present, heading vectors for your descent.
And we are re-intercepting the glide slope from above, but we'll first get the localizer in.
Feller 2-1, IA was passed.
Okay, I'm gonna set this thing over to 284.
Number 6120, Romeo, go to the ground, taxi straight ahead to parking.
There's the airfield.
Okay, Delta 1357,
San Mateo Bridge.
Approach fix request.
Flight level change down to 3,000.
Delta 1357, Roger, you can expect vectors RNAV runway 19 left approach.
There we go. Localizer is intercepted. We are on profile, so straight there up into approach mode.
Fly heading 170.
Flight slope intercept is complete. We'll take this down to 180. Prepare for flaps.
Number 221 Bravo Echo, bullhead clearance. I do have your script now. Clearance on request, standby.
I'm going to delay flaps 5 for a few more seconds because of the gusting.
Cessna 8 Yankee X-ray, contact the Ontario Tower 120.6.
Okay. Flaps 5 coming down.
United 480, contact the cabin. San Francisco Tower
120.5. 120.5, United 480, see ya.
It's around with 26 left.
Cessna 738 Yankee X-ray Ontario Tower 123012, runway 26 left, clear to land.
Runway 26 left, clear to land, 8 Yankee X-ray.
Also, I'm sorry, San Francisco Tower, United 480, 28 left.
United 480, San Francisco Tower, wind 300 at 23, gust 33, runway 28 left, clear to land.
28 left, clear to land, United 480. 300, so wind's coming out of roughly our 1 o'clock, and we are not slowing down, which is what I mentioned about this airplane being super slippery, so we'll throw out the gear as well. Arm the speed brake.
Las Vegas clearance, slippery clearance on request number 2, semi.
So that'll slow us down even more. Clearance has been received. We can now take the flaps down to 15. Usually we go straight down to flaps 20, but I'm having trouble getting the airspeed under control. There we go, flaps 20. And we'll slow down to final approach speed, which will be 145.
There's 1250, fly heading 230.
Take down, take it a couple of knots down and go
Las Vegas
to flaps
Harbor,
30.
American 178, runway 19,
landing
parking.
Checklist.
American 178, Las Vegas Tower, 180,
secure, speed brake is armed, landing
left,
gear is
off.
Down, 3 green, clear I don't know why left, this thing never lights up for me, so I need to override it, and flaps are 30.
Blue Ridge 1250, contact
LA checklist is complete.
124.85.
Right, and we are ready for manual flight, got about 1,000 feet. Gonna delay for a little bit more.
Delta 1357 contact. Las Vegas approach 135.0.
And my airplane.
Delta 1357 Las Vegas approach. Las Vegas altimeter 29035. Expect vectors. RNAV, GPS running 19 left approach.
Quite high on the approach there. What the hell's wrong?
Blue Ridge,
oh, I know what the problem
LA
is.
LA Center, the Laughlin altimeter, 29.
It's disengaged my flight director. Need to recycle the flight director here.
Clearance. Southwest 2945, ready to copy out FR to San Diego.
Southwest 2945, San Francisco, clearance delivery, clearance on request number 3, standby.
This would usually be a go-around here, but this is a simulation bug, so I'll disregard that. 500 is checked. Yeah, we are mostly stable. There we go, back on the approach course. A little bit above.
American 178, contact departure.
Departure, American 178.
Wind's coming out of the directly ahead.
Minimums.
Landing. As I said, it's not going to be a pretty landing. Yeah, I can feel the wind coming from the right a little bit there.
Clearance 1250, descend and maintain 6,500.
14, 30, 20, 10.
Yep, come on, baby. Let's set 10. You up. Oh, floated there a little bit too much.
American 178, last week's departure, radar contact.
Manual braking. Wow, that was quite a lot of wind.
Santa Barbara Tower, Cessna 2809.
And we'll even make the first exit.
2,000 feet, requesting landing.
Trades are now closed.
Landing light.
We're 2809 to Kilo Radar. Contact Wallace. Government has talked to my Charlie.
Say again. 2809 to Kilo.
Verify has talked to my Charlie. I don't have radar.
Over Juliet. Turn on the taxi lights.
Delta 1357. Fly heading 010 to center maintain 5,000. Delta 1357, these are vectors from RNAV GPS runway 19 left approach.
Okay, clear Juliet.
American 178, climb maintain, flight level 190. Blue Ridge 1250, 5 miles from Needles, fly heading 340. Cross Needles, VOR at or above 6,300, cleared. VOR 3-4 approach.
Auto throttle. Flight director off. I can't click. Weather radar is coming off. We need to wait for clearance to switch over to ground. Stop the flight timer. Yeah, San Francisco Tower United 480 clear of 28 left on Juliet. We're looking for parking Fox 90.
United 480 contact on 121.8.
0.8 for ground, United 480. Okay, switching over to ground. Need to find my buttons here. San Francisco ground, United 480, clear of 28 left on Juliet, looking for parking at Fox 80. I'm sorry, Fox 90.
United 480, San Francisco ground, taxi parking. Parking via Juliet Alpha, good night.
Juliet Alpha to parking, United 480, good night. Cool.
United 480, taxi parking, San Francisco ground, taxi parking via Juliet Alpha.
Juliet Alpha to parking, United 480. Hell.
Santa Monica ground, Cessna 536, Papa Kilo, IFR clearance.
I hope it's there.
Number 536, Papa Kilo, clearance on request, standby. King Air 221, Bravo Echo, clearance available, visor ready to copy.
So, Juliet Alpha, Alpha is the inner taxiway, sorry for looking away
King
there.
King Air 221, Bravo Echo, clear to
one,
the John Wayne Airport.
This one taxiway, this is Bravo.
Cedar to the Needles at VOR, direct Golf's VOR, then as filed. Climb maintained 7,000, expect 16,000, 10 minutes after departure. Departure
yep,
frequency, 124.85, squawk 3473.
Need to go over here, switch on the APU.
Two-two-one Bravo Echo is clear to the John Wayne Airport.
Those are the after landings
16,
complete.
Go to the Needles VOR.
Coming off.
And squawk 1473, is it?
King Air 221 Bravo Echo, clear to the John Wayne Airport, fly the runway 16 departure procedures to the Needles VOR, direct Golf's VOR, and as filed.
Radio altimeter
maintain 7,000,
expect
16,000, 10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 124.85, squawk 3473.
And the co-pilot's side as well.
John Wayne, clear John Wayne is filed, runway 16, departure procedure to Niels VOR, then Gulf 7000, expect 16000 10 minutes after departure, departure frequency 124.85, squawk 2473.
Kinger 1 Bravo Echo, squawk 3,
clear
door
left.
73.
I'm sorry, clear right and left.
3473, thank you.
Kinger 1 Bravo Echo, read it correct.
I'm going to keep on the
50, contact Laughlin Tower, one,
center
two, three,
landing light on. Actually, what we can do is turn on this thing. I'm going to turn
Cessna 8 Yankee X-ray, left turn, contact ground
4-9. Turn off lights as well.
Left turn, contact point ground 9, thank you. Good day.
Calling John Wayne for a radio deck. It was very weak, barely readable.
Gonna turn up these lights. It's a little bit of flood lights as well. That's too much.
Antero Grand, Skyhawk 738 Yankee X-ray.
There we go. It's a little bit easier to see. We can turn off the high power landing light now.
Taxi Sierra.
Number 738 Yankee X-ray out there.
The United Gates.
Sierra,
that's what they're starting. And we're parking right at the very
American
tip of this building over here.
6.35.
So we'll make a turn around over there.
Good evening, Lachlan Tower. Luch 1250 is with you on the VOR DME. 3-4, going to be circling 1-6, about 2 miles from Port Room.
Blue Ridge 1250, Laughlin Tower, wind 100-10, gust 1-5, circle east of the airport
turn.
For a right, or for a left downwind, runway 1-6, runway 1-6, clear to land.
Okay, commence a circle to the east for the left circle, 1-6, and clear to land 1-6, Blue Ridge 1250.
American 178, LA Center, climb maintain flight level 230.
APU bleed.
Calling for a radio check, it's very weak.
Looking over here on my tablet. Clear on both
Pan-Hash
sides.
Clansford, good evening, Legacy 33 Romeo Hotel with the weather. I have
Fox 90 is over here on the left.
Legacy 33 Romeo Hotel, Van Nuys clearance, clearance on request number 3, standby. American 211 clearance available.
211, ready.
American 211 cleared to Los Angeles International Airport, Boach 6 departure, Hector transition, that is filed. Climb via the SID, squawk 4237.
Okay.
We're LAX, Boach 5 departure, Hector transition.
Over there's
climb via SID.
That's gate 90 over there. Gate's open. Marshaller is in place.
American
Delta 533, descend and maintain 1515,000.
Piss off these cars.
American 211, go ahead, read back again.
Turn it in.
Now. Clear LAX, Boach 5 departure, Hector transition,
turn off the
climb via SID.
Turn off lights.
Departure frequency 125.02, squawk 4237.
Right. American 211, read back right.
And there we go. Marshaller sees us, ready for marshalling. To the left, but we're not quite on the line there. Slowing down just a touch to knots ground speed.
Las Vegas ground, American 211. Ready for taxi. I'm at the B terminal.
Kay.
Gate B1.
Parking brake is set, engines shut down.
American 211, Las Vegas ground, standby.
And we can turn off the beacon and fasten seat belts. Left pack, fuel pumps, hydraulics in the correct order. These alarms are all okay. And shut down checklist.
American 211.
Fuel pumps are off. I don't know why it thinks they are not. Flaps are up. Parking brake is set. Fuel control switches are cut off. And weather radar
okay,
is off.
One right.
Shut down checklist
Bravo
completed.
Bravo.
Wonderful. So, thanks guys for joining me up on this flight here. It was quite a tumultuous journey.
Santa Monica ground, that's no
we have arrived at our destination. We are ready to start unloading people, reloading people, and flying back.
Santa Monica ground, go ahead.
And I'll catch you in the next one.
Still waiting for IFR clearance, 536 Papa Kilo.
536 Papa Kilo, your clearance is on request.